nothing to worry about. A leaf this big will hold us up no problem. Right? You can swim? I'll pass. I don't want to get my hair wet.
Teresa, thank Shiba you're safe.
Morgana's projection appeared before her once again. She seemed relieved.
Teresa, you look different. Did something happen, my dear?
Morgana! I defeated a giant monster! You should have seen it!
Unable to contain her childish glee, Ceresa explained how they had taken down the Jabberwock.
It is a miracle you escaped unscathed. I thought I told you to find a safe place and stay put. But I must admit, I am surprised. Perhaps you have grown more than I thought.
Words of praise from Morgana were as rare as igloos in Inferno. It took all of Ceresa's willpower not to jump for joy.
I believe you're ready for more powerful magic techniques. They will allow you to draw out the true strength of your familiar. Listen, Ceresa. I have begun my preparations to get you out of that forest.
What?
The strength of the fairy magic that protects Avalon is immense. It will require an equally powerful spell to break. I have begun my incantation, but it will take until dawn to complete. You must survive until then.
Yes, ma'am.
Skill at controlling a demon determines one's worth as a witch. Remember this if you hope to take on any more monsters in that forest, and live to tell the tale.
After Morgana's spectre had vanished, Cheshire let out an angry growl.
Oh, Morgana always talks like that. Don't worry, I know you're not just some kind of weapon. But it wouldn't kill you to listen to my advice once in a while.
Cheshire snorted in response.
Ugh, you're hopeless.
And with that, Ceresa's good mood disappeared as quickly as it had come.
Moy, you managed to defeat the ferocious Jabberwock. It's hard to believe you were the same girl who I found sobbing all alone in a dark nightmare. You truly have grown strong.
Really? Thanks. You know, you still haven't told me your name.
I am Lucaon. And you?
I'm Cereza.
Cereza, what a lovely name.
Lucaon, who are you? Why are you doing so much to help me?
I am trapped deep in the heart of this forest by a powerful curse. But as a witch, I believe you have the power to break that curse. What's more...
What is it?
Your dream. You long to save your mother, don't you? That particular sorrow is one I know all too well.
You are also trying to find your mother, aren't you?
Yes. Even after countless moons, my mother still waits for me outside the forest. I want to go to her, to dry her tears. Cereza, please break my curse. If you destroy the final elemental core and come to the heart of the forest, my dream, our dream, will become a reality. We can leave this forest together. I will help you save your mother, and we can all live as families once again.
Lucaon, I understand. I'll do my best. I want to know more about you. There is so much we have in common.
I feel the same way. I have never met another who understood my pain, shared my dream.
Another meeting with Lucaon. Remembering the dream sent Cereza's young heart aflutter. Jesher noticed Cereza's flushed cheeks and stared at her inquisitively.
Hmm? Oh, it's nothing. Anyways, there is something I should explain while I have the chance.
Cereza told Jesher the reason she had entered Avalon Forest. Lucaon appearing in her dream. Her quest to save her mother, and the power she was promised that waited at the heart of the forest. Jesher was speechless. Entering the forest based on a half-remembered promise from a boy in a dream?
I know what it sounds like, but it's all coming true. The elemental cores were just as Lucaon said, right? These are more than mere dreams.
If he did not return to Inferno soon, Jesher would surely die. The thought that he was chasing the whims of a love-struck child sent his blood boiling with rage.
If I don't make it back to Inferno, the last thing I do in this miserable world will be tearing you limb from limb, roared the furious demon.
Lucaon could teach you a thing or two about how to talk to a lady. Nothing. Come on, let's go find that core.
Cerise and Cheshire came across a pool where lily pads stretched as far as the eye could see. Just how long would it take for this many to grow? They stood in awe of the forest's diligent workings.
Thank you. I'm surprised you've made it this far. You even took care of the monstrous Dreadwalk, violent even by fairy standards. I never expected a witch to come along and beat him. And you've destroyed another elemental core. But you don't seem happy. You're not hurt, are you?
No, we're fine. Hey, how about telling us where we can find the last elemental core? You know, don't you?
Yes, I've often said hurrying would lead to nowhere.
You sound like my teacher! Come on, don't hold out on us!
Dear, dear. The final elemental core is in a particularly tricky part of this forest. Inside a fortress where only the most malicious of the fairies reside. No one who has entered that fortress has ever made it out. Still sure you want to go?
Oh, we'll go, all right. I'm a witch, and I'm way stronger now than when I set foot in this forest.
We can hope. But with your teamwork, maybe you don't have much to worry about. I'm tired of those cruel fairies myself. I'm hoping you can show them what's what.
Hello!